Hello, my friends, and welcome back. Have you ever had or have those kind of friends or acquaintances for whom you do almost anything? And after you did almost everything for these people, at the end they say, that's it? That's not good enough. And what if you had this kind of people around you at one point? What would you feel? What did you feel when this happened? Did you feel satisfaction? I tell you what I feel. I feel like I will never do anything for you again. Zero. And then see how it is. In my academic endeavors and doing my readings and conversation with various people, I found that there are certain people in certain areas who are like this, who you do everything for them, and after you do everything for them, you say, they come and ask for more, and you say, well, look, I gave you this, I helped you here, I did this for you here, look how many things I did in the past. I said, yes, 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 you did that then, but what did you do for me today? So some people want you to do something or everything every single day, forever. That's the way they are. Well, I think that's my assessment. Zelensky is one of these kind of people. And I cautioned, not you, but I pointed out that he is like this maybe more than a month, maybe 2 months ago in one of my videos. And I said, this guy is not gonna have enough. The way that he uses the victim card all the time, and all the time he's not as satisfied with what he receives. He always asks for more and for more and for more. And here you have it. After all these efforts that the Western countries did for him, the populations that are right now have their leaders impose sanctions on Russia, and they have a hard time with the price on gas. Go and fill your tank and see how it is, car. The prices for food, the electricity, the energy, they all are not having a better life now because of the sanctions, they have a wars. And that's all because of, asking, oh, let's help Ukraine. Yes, and they did, with no obligations. There is no obligation, not even a moral obligation, to help these guys. Yeah, you want to help, that's good. But some people did not want to help, but they were taken in by their leaders, because that's how it's in a democracy. You vote one time, and then that person who voted for makes decisions for you 4 years or 5 years. It depends how long his or her term is. So this this is Ukrainska Pravda from May 25th, 2022, and this is the title, Zelensky. This is what he says. There is no strong and united West. Not strong. That means, he's saying that there are some ruptures. There's not all into it, into Ukraine with everything they got, which he expects that. So President Volodymyr Zelensky criticized Western countries for lacking a common position on supporting Ukraine's EU membership, NATO enlargement, and imposing sanctions on Russia. What else do you want them to do? Do you want them to send some rockets? What is that you want them to do more than they do? And they already do. Now, regarding EU membership, you can't cut the line. Or you can. The second one, NATO enlargement, you can't just cut the line again. And then imposing sanctions more? What do you want them to do? They already shot themselves in the foot with their resources, for their economies, for their societies, for their citizens. He doesn't have enough. And besides, there's another thing. This Zelensky was invited at Davos to speak for whatever reason. And he spoke and he said this right there in front of the European leaders and world leaders, let's put it this way. According to him, when it comes to unity to oppose Russia's aggression, it must not only be in words, but in everything. Did you hear that? According to him, when it comes to unity to oppose Russia's aggression, it must not only be in words, like so far they just used words, right? But in everything. Everything. What do you mean not only in words. They use words. They supplied you with weapons, with billions, tens of billions of dollars from the countries that don't have it, from me. From me. I will pay for those, for that money. My children will pay, their children will pay for the money that were given to you. Because we will be taxed for that. We have to pay it back. We didn't have it. Or the inflation is going to just jump because we just printed it and write it down. $40 billion again here. And then it's about unity. The Western countries said, oh, we're united against Russians. No, you can't be absolute like that. It's true. But still, don't, you know, take a poop on this guy's head, because not everybody is on board with your problems. Why should they all be? Is this good versus evil? It seems like. And I'm quoting, it is a question to the European Union. Tell me, please, is there unity on the European continent regarding Ukraine, regarding the future of Ukraine? Is there this unity? I haven't seen it yet. But is it fair? I don't think so, said the president, referring to discussions on granting Ukraine EU candidate status and fast track membership. So he wants something special, and then he says that, is it fair? No, it's not fair for granting you fast tracking. That's true. You're right. But he did not refer to that. He wants to be admitted yesterday. He wants to be a member of NATO last week, you know, starting last week, not in the future. And then we have here another quote from this gentleman. Look again at Finland and at Sweden. They decided to join NATO. Russia is pushing Ukraine into NATO. And then the war in Ukraine pushed Finland and Sweden into NATO. Is there now unity on the accession of Finland and Sweden to NATO? No, no, no. So, is there a strong United West? No, Zelensky said. Well, there are rules, Zelensky. You want to bend the rules? I would like to bend some rules too in my life, in a society, if you know what I mean. But I can't. I have to play along. I'm in a society. We have laws. We have to follow them. You don't like them, try to change them, you know, through the voting system and civilized process. Now you want all these rules to go away, like for instance Turkey vetoing Sweden and Finland's application to NATO. You want what, Turkey to be just kicked out of NATO? Yes, you want to change the rules as you go to fit your interest, but you don't consider the Turkey's interests. So why should Turkey consider your interest but it should not consider its interest, or the European Union's? Let's say Hungary has questions regarding certain things. So why should Hungary consider your concerns, but you don't seem to be concerned about their safety, security, economic problems that might be, you know, occurring after they do what you want them to do? This is very selfish. And Zelensky also criticized the EU's inability to agree on an oil embargo against Russia because of Hungary's resistance. Yes, and the Turkey was with the NATO. Yes, Zelensky, do you care for the Ukrainians? Let's put it this sneaky. Do you care for the Ukrainian people? Well, so does Orban for his Hungarian people. The same rule that applies to you applies to them too. Do you care for the Hungarian people? Then shut up about an oil embargo. Oh, no? Okay, so see how it is? I want you to do what I want you to do for me, but I will not do anything if I would reverse roles. Every time you ask someone, to do something for you, see if you would do the same thing. Because let's say I ask to be tolerant. I want you to be tolerant. Well, asking you to be tolerant is asking you to change something that I want. That means I put pressure and I'm the intolerant because I want you to be tolerant. So if I would be tolerant, I would just let you be however you want to be. I would tolerate your ideas. I would tolerate your decisions. But no, I ask you to tolerate my decisions. But do I tolerate your ideas, your decisions? No. And I call you intolerant if you don't do that. So Zelensky, as I said, what did you do for me today? And by the way, bend the rules. It's unbelievable, but that's reality. That's reality. And this is the guy that everybody finances. And I knew that because it's not hard to see through him. Look at him. Look at him. Check on him. I can't say more. It's just that. That's a certain kind of people who, you know, sometimes are saved from death. And then after that's all gone, they come back and say, hey, you didn't save enough of us. Thank you very much for being with me again today. Stay strong, stay smart, look for the truth, and be just.